Here's my latest progress on the Raspberry Pi Pip-Boy 3000. Okay, here's the in-game Pip-Boy. I'm trying to recreate the map there. Now I want to try to make it do the local map, automatically generate it, based on GPS coordinates. Now I've recently got myself a GPS module. There it is. That's connected up to the Raspberry Pi's GPIO pins. And I've managed to actually get position out of that, although it isn't working right now because I'm indoors, so it can't see any satellites. However, I've also... There's my that screen thing again. I've managed to get Python to download Google Maps with various customized settings, tint it green, and display. Now that's a bit of central Leeds there, where I am. That can use GPS coordinates. I've managed to get that working before, but as I said, that isn't working right now because I'm indoors. But I'll make it. Well, I'm planning to make it use the last found GPS coordinates if it can't find any. I need to make that scrolly as well, but at the moment I've just downloaded a large image and displayed the middle of it. Okay, what else? The problem with that TFT screen is that it runs on 6 volts and the Raspberry Pi runs off 5 volts. Now I've recently got a ubec, which is a power conversion device that that regulates the power. So I'm now running both these things off the same power supply. I've got 6 volt power supply there, that's feeding directly into there, and that's converting the 6 volts to 5 volts of the Pi. Okie dokie. Oh yes, electronics. I think I've basically got the control electronics sorted, or at least the basic layout. These will need to be properly like soldered up in it and things like that. And I also need to make something for sound as well, which will be a separate project, but okay. The way I'm doing this, the way I'm doing the controls for the Pip-Boy, I'm running all these components through, that's a Teensy 3, which is a Arduino-compatible microchippy microprocessor fella, which has built-in ability to pretend to be a keyboard, which is the reason I originally bought that. I can also pass serial information through as well, but yeah, specifically for the keyboard that I'm using at the moment. I had a go at just working straight off the GPIO bits, which would be easier for other people to play around with if they've got a Raspberry Pi, if they wanted to copy me. But there's just not enough pins, and it seemed a bit fiddly to me, seeing as I already have this thing. So, yeah, if you want to copy what I'm doing, you're going to have to get one of these. I've got it programmed to, if these are pressed, that presses the keyboard 1, 2 and 3, and of course lights these up. Those are going to be these fellows here, beep beep beep. Got 2 rotary encoders, one of which will be this thing. The other one is going to be the dial that's on the hand that you can't quite see here, and that also pushes in, so I'll be able to turn it and press it, which will be useful for entering information. I've currently got that set up to left and right arrows and enter, and I've got that set up to up and down arrows, and once the software here is completed, that'll well, if I just have a keyboard plugged in, it'll be compatible with just pressing those buttons, but yeah, so I could work it with a keyboard, or I can work it with this device. What else have we got on here? This button I've got set up as spacebar, and that's actually a button you can't quite see here, that's up here, there. I've got to work out exactly how the data entry is meant to work. It's a very confusing system, and I'm not sure how, if it works entirely perfectly with one-handed entering. It's like, how are you meant to press that and turn that at the same time? It's not, yeah, it's not as useful as having a mouse, but yeah, it should work. The twiddly knob here, I've got a rotary switch, which has actually got 12 positions, but I'm only using 5 of them. When that gets turned, it'll click, but I can't because it's... I have to do that with two hands. That presses 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 when it's turned, and I could add secret alternative things as well, alternative screens. But yeah, there's five turns on there, and that flicks between these fellas. Now you'll see this is a really weird rotary encoder that's back to front. Now what I can do with this, the reason I got this was, put that down for a sec. The pull comes off, and I can have a knob attached to there. And that's a nice low profile switch now. If I bend these back anyway, it will be. Now, I've got 3D model set up in 3D Studio Max of the where all these bits are going to go. And it's going to be a tight fit for some of these. Once I actually get my 3D printer and it's up and running, I'll actually be able to tell if all this will work, but I might need to scale things up and down a bit to just fit stuff in. Is that everything here? I think so. Yep, here's the GPS module. I think I showed you that earlier. Got the Wi-Fi running. Oh, I've got a camera, the Raspberry Pi camera, which has not really got any purpose for the Pip-Boy project, but yeah, it's a nice little thingy. Okay, that'll do for now. Just show you the map once more. Yeah, I'll need to put some grid lines on that and all the markers and just build it into the user interface in general. Good stuff. Okay, good night.